today, mm-hmm. and we're going to want to look for very good quality, relevant courses mm-hmm. and training opportunities.
Okay, Minister, we're here at Pathways to Work. Can you tell me about how this is going to aid people to come out of long-term unemployment and to reskill?
Well, I mean, the responsibility that I have is ensuring that when people are referred through the NICE process, through Minister Burton's referral programme, they come to me, they come to Solace, our new further education and training authority. I have to ensure that their experience with Solace is a very, very positive one.
Could you tell me your name and the programme you're doing and how you got involved?
I'm Gerry Eaters, and I'm on the content stream of the Web Elevate, and specifically this semester it's video for web. And basically my background is architectural technology, coming from a construction background, but that kind of dried up. So basically I was looking, I'd accumulated a kind of a bag of skills to do with web editing, graphic design, all those kind of presentation skills that I'd used in my previous industry, the architectural technology industry.
My name's Anthony O'Rourke. I'm doing the Web Elevate course, and I got wind of the course online and also at the social welfare. They had a poster up of the course, and as soon as I saw it, I went, that's the one for me. Mm-hmm. So it's enabled me, it's given me a path to a qualification to eventually get back to work.
My name is Kenneth Murphy. I'm currently in the content stream in the animation and design department. And my background would have been graphic design for a newspaper. I was working in the advertising section. But then in late 2008, as well, a lot of print businesses, it folded. So I've been going around looking for any sort of job ever since.
My name is Kim McKayed, and I'm in the Web Elevate program in the project management stream. And this semester we're focusing on applied project management in media production.
In the document that was handed out today, there was several case examples. One of them was an unemployed construction worker at 24. Can you give me an example of how, what your department's role would be and what Solace's role would be in helping this kind of a person to get back into employment?
There are roughly 80,000 primarily young people from the construction sector who now find themselves out of work because of the collapse of that particular sector. And the challenge is there is a very wide gap of skills levels. You have people who left school immediately after junior cert and went to work as labourers on the building site, all the way up to people with, you know, degrees and masters and even PhDs in civil engineering and architecture and so on. So there's a very wide cohort of people we have to address, and we're now beginning to develop a number of programmes for those people. For those who have perhaps trades like plumbers and electricians and carpenters and so on, we're looking at opportunities emerging in the green economy, in passive house design, in passive house construction, in thermal insulation, in wind turbine erection and maintenance. And then when you go further up the skills ladder, up towards the people who are the civil engineers and the drafts persons and the architects, many of whom we met here today, we're looking at taking their innate mathematical and logistical and analytical skills and channeling them in another direction, away from construction, perhaps into the ICT sector, or even what we saw here today, into web marketing, web design and so on. So we're taking the skills that they have and the natural talent that they have, but offering them an opportunity to take it in a completely different direction. And that's something that we have to do, and we're very much ambitious that we will be able to do that.
And do you find that a lot of your classmates, like a high percentage of your classmates, have come to this course following the collapse of the construction industry?
I see a lot of architects and technologists here. Yeah, I've met a lot of them. I think it is, like, the good, one of the really good things about this course is the people here that are honest, unbelievably creative people, like, blow your mind, talented, amazing. All displaced, all with a similar story, you know, displaced from a particular industry under different circumstances, but with massive amounts of talent. So it is a good way of refocusing the skills on a particular area that has the potential, I suppose, for growth.
When you're doing an individual course, you can feel very isolated. You'll be looking around and seeing people doing all this, and you're thinking, gosh, how the heck are they doing this? Because I have no idea. And again, you might ask a lecturer in that situation and they mightn't even know. But here, because it's the group, there's also sort of peer learning, where you can ask someone across the table, do you know how to do this? And they'll say, yes, I'll show you how. And I've been able to advise people myself and things that I might know that they don't know. So it's more of a natural, organic learning experience than standard college would be?
We'll also be liaising very, very closely with industry and enterprise, both at national and at regional level, to ask them, you know, what are your training needs? Where will the skills shortages be occurring in your particular sector over the next 3, 4, 5, or 10 years? And then channeling and directing our training opportunities to fill those particular vacancies.
Have you had any contact with any industry partners?
Yeah, I'm actually working on a project now with the Education Company of Ireland. They've got a lot of their e-books online at the moment, which are just kind of in static kind of PDF format, you know, so they're trying to revamp their whole thing with videos and animations and make it more interactive and enjoyable for the students and teachers. So it's really fun getting involved in projects like that, you know, and using your creativity, like, you know, alongside the technical stuff. So
one of the main attractions for me about this course was the contact with industry partners. So I'd see that as the main focus of being able to get in with live industry partners. Like they have us working with Oracle on some of their branding and placement within the online community kind of thing. So I see that as a major aspect of the course. So I suppose that's really where they've come good on the whole helping you get into the industry.
In the past, we perhaps focused too much on numbers, on throughput, on kind of priding ourselves in that we trained maybe 70 or 80,000 people in a year. We never really honed in, focused in on how effective the training was, how effective the intervention was. We never asked the people who engaged in the training what it meant to them, whether it led them on to further education or further training opportunities, or whether it led them back to work. So we need to restore people's trust, because they've lost trust in our training system, both the people accessing the training and industry and enterprise who need to have a pipeline of very highly skilled people coming to them. They've lost trust in FOSS, in the work that it was doing. We're now about restoring that trust under a new entity called Solace, which will bring further education and training together under one umbrella for the first time. And we'll be focusing on outcomes, outcomes, outcomes all the time, constantly accessing information about whether we were successful or unsuccessful in training a person, and using that information to design programs for the future.
And what's your plan when you're finished the course? Are you going to go and look for employment?
Yeah, definitely, you know, continue with project management, but in the media industry and entertainment.
It depends on the current situation by the time I leave here at the start of October, because again, things are changing so rapidly. Technology changes and job demands change and skills change, so hopefully I will be able to get a job, but otherwise I'll go back into education and expand my knowledge further.
I'm thinking maybe go for a master's maybe, and then see. If not, go get a job and, you know, maybe a year or two down the line continue on with the education.
I've been looking around at some kind of startup ideas, freelance type work, and it's just basically looking for the new opportunities that maybe haven't been explored or presented, and I think there's an opportunity to do that.
And you said that there's an ambitious target set of 75,000 people, I think,
it was, yes,
by
this
the
year.
End of this year.
Yes, yeah.
Do you think that's going to be a challenge to meet? Do you think it's realistic?
It's not a challenge, and it never has been a challenge for FOSS to put people through its books. It's because it's got the infrastructure to do that. I mean, you know, accessing 75,000 people isn't difficult. Giving them a high quality experience and a high quality training experience is challenging, but FOSS, even now, before Solace comes into being, is very, very very much enthusiastic about being able to do that. And they are constantly researching to see where the skills shortages are occurring. And they're setting aside all the courses of the past that now lead to nowhere, and rapidly putting in place new programs that will lead people directly into work.